Alright, Shalom. First off, I want to give all praises, honor, and glory to Yahweh, by Hashem, Yahweh Shah. Double honors to the apostles and the elders of Great Millstone. And it's sincere Shalom to all the Akim out here that is doing and pushing the work in truth and in sincerity. Okay? The ones that are a part of the hopeful elect. Okay? I just wanted to go into this topic of, you know, when it comes down to GMS, we know that there are wicked men amongst us, you know, wicked brothers, you know, so to say. We know that there are wicked people, period, you know, whether it's in GMS or outside of GMS. And the thing is that, you know, when you come into this truth, one thing that you have to realize is that it's not going to be all peaches and cream, man, you know, to get to the kingdom, okay? If you are a man of the Lord, first off, the Lord is going to direct you into the right doctrine, you know? And just because, you know, you might have one person who you may think is off, you know, that don't mean that everybody in the camp is off or everybody in the camp is wicked, you know? Coming into this truth, you know, you have to wipe off the ways of this world, you know, and you know, you have to realize that, you know, brothers are in the flesh, you know, and just because brothers are in the flesh, you know, that don't mean that, you know, that they, that they're a part of the two-thirds, you know, or that they're just straight up the most wicked people out here. But here go the thing. You had people that was back in the day that knew that they was Israelites, and they was just the most wicked people out here, man. Okay? Some of the most wicked people are going to know that, you know, that the truth, you know? And that's just how things are set up, okay, in this truth, okay? And it's crazy because you have people out here, you know, from the outside looking in, you know, want to scoff and come at the men of the Lord for doing videos or, you know, doing whatever brothers are doing. You know what I'm saying? They're coming off and making it seem like, you know, everybody in GMS is wicked and, you know, guys got to get out GMS in order to make it. When that's not the truth, man, you know? The doctrine is pure, okay? And people get caught up on man, you know? But with that said, I just wanted to go into some scriptures, you know, on basically, you know, we know that there are wicked people that are among us, but at the end of the day, we know that through the spirit and power of Yahweh Hashem Yahweh Shah, we have faith that, you know, he's going to sift those people that are wicked, you know, out, you know. But this is John 6:64. It says, but there are some of you that believe not, which there are some people in Great Millstone who don't really believe everything that is being said, you know. They don't believe that the apostles are men of the Lord, or that their camp leaders are men of the Lord, or that people under them are men of the Lord, okay? They don't even believe in Yahweh Shah. It says, for Yahweh Shah knew from the beginning who they were that believed not and who should betray him, okay? So the Lord knows at the end of the day who are his men and who aren't his men, okay? It says, and he said, therefore, I said unto you that no man can come unto me except it were given unto him of my Father. Okay, so the thing is that, you know, no man, you know, if we're looking at this thing from a spiritual standpoint, no man can come into this truth, okay, and say, you know, the name Yahweh Basim Yahweh Shah, okay, whether you're a demon or, you know, an angel, whatever the case may be, you're not going to come to this truth, except it was given unto unless the Father sent them. Okay, so the Lord is in complete control of everything. Okay, it says, from that time, many of his disciples went back and walked no more with him. Okay, so it's going to be guys that just go back into the world, you know what I'm saying, and scoffers are going to say, oh yeah, get out, you know, get out GMS. And they would prefer people to just go back into the world and hear nothing else from them, you know? Whereas though, you know, we encourage people to continue to do this work. You know, we don't say, you know, just, you know, stop doing. We say teach, man. You know, go out here and continue to push this word, man. You know, not just go back into the world, man. Because once you go back into the world, you know, it's better that you never even knew righteousness in the first place, man. You know, it says, then said Yahweh Shalom to the 12, will you also go away? Then Simon Peter answered him, Lord, to whom shall we go? Thou hast the words of eternal life. Okay, and when you look at Great Millstone, where we going to go at, man? If everybody in Great Millstone left, you know, where are they going to go at? You know, what other group out here is actually teaching, you know, on a whole, who the words of eternal life, man? You know? This is a group effort, man. You know? It's a body. And if you just straight, oh, the elders not my elders no more, you know, the apostles aren't the apostles no more, you just go do your own thing, well, the scriptures that say, let the elders that rule well, you know, be counted worthy of double honors, you know, that scripture got to apply to somebody. So who do that scripture apply to, man? Are you going to go to IUIC, ISUBK, or any of these other groups, or just do your own thing? Well, that scripture still has to apply to somebody, man, you know, to some elder out here, okay? So it's about who you gonna give that double honor to, you know? It says, to whom shall we go? Thou has the words of eternal life. And we believe in our sword that thou art Yahweh Shah, Hamashiach, okay? The son of the living power, Yahweh. Yahweh Shah answered them, have I not chosen you 12 and one of you is a devil? He spake of Judas Iscariot, the son of Simon, for he it was that should betray him, being one of the 12. So Yahweh Shah knew that Judas was going to betray him, man. And Judas was not one of them people that, you know, at that time that walked by. He was walked with Yahweh Shah all the way up until the end, till he betrayed them. You know? So how much more if you know, the Lord knew who Judas was, okay, and that he was a devil, you know what I'm saying? How much, and he told them, man, to their face that, you know, he knew that one of them 12 was a devil, man. You know, and Judas probably was cut to the spirit, man, from off of that. You know, he probably was sitting up there thinking like, oh, I hope it ain't me, you know what I'm saying? So how much more a guy that's in Great Millstone, you know what I'm saying, that's going to play the field, man, you know, just to get what they can get out of it, man, you know. Now, that don't mean everybody in Great Millstone is a Judas. That just means that in this camp you might have a Judas, you might have, in another camp you might have a nigga that's an agent, you know, in another camp you might have just a straight up wicked nigga who might not be doing, or another camp you might have a nigga that's not even putting up videos and stuff like that. You know, it's always an example somewhere along the line of somebody that isn't doing what they supposed to do at the end of the day. Okay, it's John 13 and 16. Verily, verily, I say unto you, the servant is not greater than his Lord, neither he that is sent greater than he that sent him. Okay, so the ones that are pushing the word, okay, which we're all considered servants unto the Lord, okay, you have guys out here that may think that they're greater than Yahweh Shah, man. You know, in Great Millstone, you have guys that put on garments and stuff like that, and they, I'm talking about Mac 10, you know what I'm saying, put on the garments like Yahweh Shah, and he make it seem like, you know, he is Yahweh Shah. You know, the guys that think that they're equal, you know, like they can die for Israel, or that they can save themselves, you have them guys out here like that, man. You know, it says, if you know these things, happy are you if you do them. I speak not of you all, okay, because it's not all of us, man. You know, you have some sincere brothers, which I hope that I'm one of the sincere brothers, man. You know, you have to the continually reflect, you know, examine yourself, man. You know, whether you're in the spirit or not. Okay, it says, I know whom I have chosen, which we all hope at the day that we are chosen. Okay, whether it's the wicked niggas or whatever, man, brothers still hope that they're chosen. We don't know, okay, the Lord didn't choose you, you know, until the Lord makes it manifest. It says, but that the scripture may be fulfilled, he that eats bread with me have lifted up his heel against me. You know, and that's talking about Judas, but then we also got brothers that are eating bread with us, and they might be agents, might just turn us in, man. You know? But that's all according to what the Lord wants done, man. Because as the scriptures say, you know, no man can come unto the Lord unless the Lord sent them, man. Or gave them, you know? It says, now I tell you before it come, that when it come to pass, you may believe that I am he. Verily, verily, I say unto you, he that receives whoever I send receives me. And he that receives me receives him that sent me. Okay? Now, continuing on, it's just Psalms 118 and 8. It is better to trust in the Lord than to put confidence in man. Okay? So, if you see a God that is straight up a nigga, you know, you might have a nigga that just straight up sleep with your woman or something like that. And it might be a brother in your camp, you know? You don't sit up there and get off the course, you know, towards Yahweh Basim Yahusha. You know, you got to trust in the Lord that, hey, this nigga is wicked, so the Lord going to put him to death. And, hey, if them niggas, if somebody is doing that type of shit, you know, we going to reprove that. We going to rebuke that shit first off, man. We get on our own, you know, all the time. Okay, this is Ephesians 5 and 11. And have no fellowship with the unfruitful works of darkness. Okay, we not guys that are coming together and rolling up blunts and, you know, trying to smash other niggas' wives and stuff like that. We not in that type of shit, man. It says, but rather reprove them. Okay? So we have to rebuke, man, and reprove, man. Okay? But like I said, you know, it's better to trust in the Lord than to put confidence in man. Okay? And that confidence even goes down to ourself, man. Okay? This is Isaiah 64 and 6. But we are all as an unclean thing. Everyone in Great Millstone, you can look at all of us, man, and say, oh, yeah, he's wicked. He's wicked. You know, we all unclean. It says that all of our righteousnesses are as filthy rags. And we all do fade away. I mean, fade as a leaf, and our iniquities like the wind have taken us away. You know, so everything, all of us are like filthy rags, man. You know, you got people that may have known us growing up that's going to look at us and say, hey, man, you know, you the same guy that was doing this, that, whatever in the past, man. You know, you're going to have people that, and that's what these scoffers do, too. You know, this guy was doing this in the past. You know what I'm saying? Yeah, he was a drug dealer. Somebody could have been a straight up murderer in the truth, man. You know? But that don't mean that they not men of the Lord. You got the examples. You know, Paul was murdering the men of the Lord before, man. You know, the Lord allows us to repent, you know, to change our ways. You know, you guys could have been anything in this world, man. You know, but the brothers that are out there, for the most part, you know, we all, you know, repented. You know, for the most part, we can't look at somebody and say, oh, you didn't repent. You know, think inside their prayers and stuff like that. If a brother say that they sorry for offending you, you can't prove that brother is really sorry, man. You know, you just got to go with the spirit, man. If they really sorry, then, you know, hey, we got to forgive them. But if they not, and they say that they sorry, the Lord going to deal with them. That's just a part of the faith, man. You know, but at the end of the day, we all, at the end of the day, have something that's going on with us, man, that we can always do better, man, you know, and we can't just look at somebody and just say, oh, you a straight up nigga. That guy you might be looking at might be a nigga that you think might be a nigga, you know, might be one of the elect. If they not doing something that's straight up, I'm talking about out of this world wicked, you know. This is Colossians 3 and 23, and whatsoever you do, do it heartily as to the Lord and not unto men. Okay? So when we get on people and do these things, go out there on a highway and hedges, you know, we not out there with garments on to try to, you know, bring people with or real people in and say, hey, nice garment and shit like that, man. You know? We out there wholeheartedly for y'all by some of y'all side because the Lord is going to get his glory. Okay? And you got people out there that are out there for men. you know. It says knowing, and they, those people that are out there for men, you know, they just an example of what not to be. You're going to have those examples all the time, man. Okay? It says, knowing that of the Lord you shall receive the reward of the inheritance, for you serve the Lord, Yahweh Shah. You know? So we out there serving Yahweh Shah, man, the hopeful elect. That's what we really hoping for, man. You know, to get saved up out of here, man. You know? It says, but he that doeth wrong shall receive for the wrong which he have done. And there is no respect of person. So if a nigga is a nigga, that nigga is going to get the reward of a wicked nigga. Okay? And I believe it's a scripture. Where it talks about, you know, the Lord is going to come back with this reward. Okay? Revelation 22 and 12. And behold, I come quickly, and my reward is with me. You know, so the people that do wrong, they're going to receive that wrong for that wrong that they did. You know, it says to give every man according to his, according as his work shall be. So if a nigga is a nigga that's in his truth, you know what I'm saying? Hey, Yahweh Shah is going to come back and deal with those guys, man. You know, but that should not get somebody out of this truth or having people look at the whole entire great millstone as if the Lord ain't dealing with them just because you got one or two people that are wicked, you know? This is Philippians 2:12. Wherefore, my beloved, as you have always obeyed, not in my presence only, but now much more in my absence, okay? You got guys, you know, think, oh, Apostle Tahar or the apostles are supposed to look at every single camp. You know what I'm saying? Everything that brothers do, you know, every video that brothers say, you know, every social media thing, and, you know, that they're supposed to just observe every single thing, you know? Yeah, you can't do that, man. You know, it's physically impossible to look at every video that every brother puts up, you know? And the thing is, at the end of the day, if somebody is teaching a false doctrine, hey, The Lord always makes it known, man, that he brings it out on the forefront, man. You know? And those guys that do bring out them false doctrines, they get kicked out. You know? So it's not that guys are just slacking on their jobs or, you know, guys are just straight up wicked. The Lord deals with stuff on his time, man. Not on our time. Okay? And that's what you have to realize when you come into this truth. It says, work out your own salvation with fear and trembling. Okay, so just because you see a nigga that's moving around with no fear, no trembling, you gotta look at that and see, hey, the Lord might deal with that, man, but hey, I gotta make sure that I'm good, man, you know, that I'm doing what the hell I gotta do, you know, and that's what we encourage other people to do, man. We exhort that, man, you know. This is Psalms 119:71. It is good for me that I have been afflicted. So you're gonna have them so-called niggas that in the truth, and Apostle Tahar said, hey, it might be niggas that or guys in Great Millstone who might already had a chip right now, you know? They might already had a chip right now, you know? Hey, they might be striking as the scriptures say, you know, striking their fellow servants, you know? Their brothers and stuff like that, you know, getting on them and, you know, just straight up being a straight up demon. But that person that's being a straight up demon, you know, to another brother, if that brother is in the right spirit, you know, that brother is learning. Okay, he should be learning. Okay, and he should be looking at that person that's afflicting him as a man of the Lord. Well, yeah, he should be looking at him as a man of the Lord because we don't know. You know, it's all spiritual. It says, it is good for me that I've been afflicted that I might learn thy statutes. Okay, how to walk in this life, man. Okay, and I said that he should be looking at it like that's a man of the Lord. I got this scripture, Psalm 141:5. Let the righteous smite me, it shall be a kindness. And let him reprove me, it shall be an excellent oil, which shall not break my head, for yet my prayers also shall be in their calamities. You know? So brothers, when brothers get on people or reprove people and say this, that, or whatever about things, hey, even when brothers get on the so-called black women, man, you know, it's a lot of that going on. You know, we not supposed to be in no simp mentality or trying to protect these women and stuff like that, you know, But hey, even when brothers get on women, you know, you got guys that sit up there, oh, you're not supposed to get on this woman. You know, hey, that's my queen. Yeah, them guys don't understand how this spirit goes, man. You know? Or you guys in Great Millstone, Wicked, every one of you. You know? And we even say that there's some guys that may be in these other camps a part of the elect, man. You know? They just got to come in the right doctrine, man. You know? And be in the right spirit. Because that's what it's all about, man. About serving y'all, about some of y'all side truthfully, man, in righteousness, man. You know? But with that, you know, at the end of the day, you know, it's a straight gate. Everybody is going to be able to get through them gates, man. You know, but we striving to get through that, man. If you think, you know, you can just do whatever you want to in this truth, you're not on the right path, man. You know? So you're supposed to be striving to enter into the straight gate. You know? We over here at Great Millstone, we're going to give it to you straight, raw, uncut, you know, unfiltered. You know, the good, the bad, and the ugly. You know, you gonna get the whole truth and nothing but the truth over here, man. You know, brothers are supposed to keep it real, okay? And keeping it real is knowing that hey, you might have niggas that might be along amongst you, man. You know, but that don't mean that they might not be a men of the Lord. And I'm talking about the guys that are men of the Lord, man. I mean, aren't men of the Lord, man. You know, those guys are still necessary evils. You know, for the elect to get it, but at the end of the day, those necessary evils are going to be done with, man. You know, by the spirit and power of Yahweh by Shem Yahusha. Okay, that's where the faith comes in that. Okay, so with that, you know, hopefully this was edifying. You know, I want to say Shalom till next time.